What's going on? Isn't this setup amazing? By the way, Robert Mayrovich, my partner, this is amazing what he did without any experience in production and with amazing support team. So, Robert, you're the man. Thank you so much for that. Okay, so forgive me for my broken English and from being nervous. Today I was invited over here to talk to you. just to share a little bit about the story of the company and why we all got here together. And I'm not telling the story, even though I don't like to say it again and again. It's a very emotional ride for me to say over and over. I know that most of you maybe heard it. But this story is a simple story of certain people with certain incidents and luck and loyalty and dedication that created what we are celebrating here today. Yeah. And sharing this story with you, I think if you want to take something out of it, is that anybody in this story could be one of you. With no proper training before, with no proper education to do what we did, without any strategic planning, with just life happened to us, and it's just the beginning of it, so when you hear it, just see where you fit in, and I'm sure you are because you're here, so you're part of this story, but how to make it even bigger. So the story goes back 12 years ago, when my brother Moti, which I love him, is the best thing that ever happened to me in my life, he just decided to come over here and look for an opportunity, just a temporary job, work on an ice cream truck. And why a temporary job and why ice cream truck? In Israel, we service 3 years in the military. And because of that, our parents support us while we service in the military. We don't get paid, almost not at all, $40 a month. And after the military, we have to do something with ourselves because our parents say, okay, now just do something with yourself. You know, most parents say after you celebrate, we work so hard 3 years and then we come and they say, okay, now just go and do something with yourself. Not that it's enough to sacrifice your life for 3 years in the military because you have no money, so most of us go and look for an opportunity to work on a temporary job because that's the highest paid jobs out there, to save some money, start our studies, build our families, like everybody else. I wanted to imagine that because here it's different. So we finish high school, you go to college, we go to war. It's the same amount of time, 3 years, right? So we missed the best time of the life. So usually when we go out of the military, something is wrong with us because we didn't have this good time with our friends and hanging out. We usually look for something outside of Israel so we can experience something fun, not just work and save money. And this is how Moti got here to Texas. He knew some friends, attended some ice cream truck. He said, okay, I'm gonna work, I'm gonna save some money and go travel to South America and start my life. I actually wanted to go to medical school. And coming here, working on an ice cream truck for 6 months, he started saving some money and he said, I know, why should I rent my truck? I should buy it. So he bought his first truck and then he decided to stay a little bit more. He already owned a truck. Maybe he should stay more and make more money. So then he's buying another truck and then he's buying another truck. So he is building his ice cream empire over here. And for me in Israel, when I heard about it, I was really proud. You know, my brother, he owns a business and I'm still fighting, you know, in the trenches in the military. But when I came over here and I see it in my eyes, you know, it's the ice cream trucks in the streets, you know, with the kids running all over the place. And I never believed that my brother would do it. It's hot, it's Texas. So you sweat, there is no AC in those cars. So it's kind of an experience. But anyway, I can go on and on. My brother was talking to me. I was 7 years in the military, at the beginning of the Air Force and then intelligence forces. And my brother would talk to me and say, Izhak, you have to come, join my business. We can build the empire together. me and my brother, we had rough childhood, very rough childhood. Because of us, not because anybody else. We used to fight all the time. And those of you that know Moti, it wasn't really a match because he's bigger, he's stronger, he's smarter than me. So even with my parents, I couldn't get away with it because I would get beat and he would get all the credit for that. He's a politician. So anyway, my dad, he really couldn't stand it because he knew that something is wrong. He told us all the way, you know, until you guys gonna work together, I'm not gonna be happy. So he pushed us to work together, and 28 years in the military makes somebody really tough on us. So he used to give us the proper training all of our childhood on how to behave. And when we failed to really work as brothers, they were really sad and upset. But you know, life happened, and high school, and then yeah, he was recruited to the military, and then me, and then everybody forgot about our deal. So when Moti called me, he said, you know, Izhak, maybe this is the time to prove that yes, we can work together. And we became good friends because we were away from one each other, of course, talking on the phone once in a while. So when Moti called me, I was not ready for any move from Israel. I was so happy with my military position. I was an intelligence officer. I was a captain in the military, and I was presenting operations to the prime minister. I was so happy. I didn't even think about doing anything else. And ice cream trucks? Why would I do that? But my brother, he lives in his own dream and his own life. He thought that everything is around this amazing venture that he built because he knew better than all of us. So I decided it's about time. I took a flight, actually took a vacation from my service. I signed up for 5 more years. It was 7 years already in the military. And when I came to visit, my brother, of course, he doesn't care why, what's the purpose of my visit. He just tell me, okay, Izhak, now that you joined my business. And it was I remember it was 4 p.m. when I landed in Houston. With my bags, he gave me a key to a car. He said, okay, you have to drive to Corpus Christi because the driver is sick over there. You have to go and drive the ice cream truck tonight. You have to prepare it for tomorrow morning because you have to learn how to work. And you can't manage an organization without really working it. You know, when I'm looking at it, I say, what are you surprised? You think you're going to manage something like this? You know, do you know anything? Go and drive the ice cream truck. Prove yourself. So I'm overwhelmed with all this information. I said, okay, I have to do something and I can't do anything. So I just took the car. My first time in America, driving in the US highways without knowing what's going on. Of course, working my first day on an ice cream truck, which I thought it's fun, but I cried all day. I was 25 years old. I was in charge of taking down terror cells in the Middle East, and I couldn't drive an ice cream truck. I was embarrassed. Something bigger, you just drive the car in the street with, that's it, you know, you don't even have a route. So I said, okay, Izhak, you know, be a man, just go confront your brother, you know, just take charge, because otherwise you're gonna be buried here your entire vacation. Now, it was my first vacation since I was 18. I was already 25. It's the first time I see my brother after 4 years, and what I'm doing, I'm driving an ice cream truck. And I can't even enjoy it. So anyway, I did it for 3 weeks because I couldn't even confront my brother. I think it was the best thing that ever happened to us, because in these 3 weeks, when I was playing with an ice cream truck and internal thoughts about becoming a man and challenge my brother, he thought that it's time to tell my parents that this is it, me and Izhak are going to build a family business and they should take everything they have, sell their house and everything they own, send the money to us and take a flight because that's it, this is it. So you can imagine what happened to me when I came to Houston and my brother told me that our parents are on the way from Israel and they sold everything and they wired the money to his bank account and they're ready to build a business.